this doesn't make any sense. What in the is it getting caught on?
Is it loose enough? Like, is the bolts all the way off?
I mean, my God, they're gonna fall out. What are you guys doing? Look at you! Look at you climbing! Holy smokes! What do you think Mom's gonna say? We'll go by her right there. She's standing out in the field with Vanny. Watch. Nope, she doesn't know what the hell we're doing. All right, so what are we doing, Lib?
Getting gas.
And why are we getting gas?
Because the tractor ran out of gas.
Yeah, because I ran out of gas. Way out on the north field, right?
Yeah.
Yep, about as far away as you can be. Really long walk?
Yeah.
I'm not walking back. What should we do? Any ideas?
No.
No? I got an idea. So, is this a good plan? All right, we'll take your car. Well, there's the tractor. Well, this is what happens when you run out of gas when you're out here collecting all this hay, isn't it? This is why we need a baler. Ultimately, I really don't know what to do with this land. I think that the leading option right now is to put some chickens on it, but I'm gonna call on you. Go in the comments, tell me what you think. What should we do with this land? There's so many options and so many things that we can do. And if you're enjoying this video, do me a favor, hit that like button. When I put the dock in, it really slanted off to one side. I probably should just leave it and deal with it later, but being that my OCD is going crazy, it's kind of driving me nuts. So I'm gonna try to make the repair in the water. And the reason I can't pull it out is because the grass is finally starting to come in a little bit here. I really don't want to wreck that with the tractor. I got an idea and a plan. You'll probably never see anybody try and fix a dock or level a dock this way ever again. So basically the plan is I have a pipe spanning across the dock, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use it as a lever. So we're gonna go to one side of it, we're gonna lift up a couple of inches, we're gonna tighten the bolts down in place, we're gonna go to the other side, we're gonna lift up a couple of inches, and then we're gonna tighten those bolts, and we're gonna go back and forth repeating this process until this thing is level. We'll see how it goes.
This doesn't make any sense. That one's in there hand tight, and so is this.
Well, as you can see, it's not going great. We've managed to basically move the dock about 4 inches the wrong direction.
It's bad, but it's not bad getting it.
It's more so that I sink in and I don't want to get stuck.
You're not going to get stuck.
You don't know that.
What's going to happen if you get stuck? I'll pull you out.
Once we came to the realization that we just needed to stop fighting it, it started to actually work pretty good. I was able to go from one side to the other side while Sarah either tightened or loosened the bolts, and slowly but surely it started to go up and up and up.
That's where my wrench is. I looked all over for this yesterday.
Is it in the ground?
No, it was in this bag.
Oh.
Whoa, look at that. It went up by itself. Up by itself. All by myself. See that? Good job.
This is like a circus out here. It's awesome. All right, let's get all this stuff put back. Good job. Looks good though. I can't believe that it actually worked. Good for you. All right, go get them. Took us a little while to figure out a rhythm, but once we got that rhythm established, Sarah and I were able to go pretty fast back and forth and really get it leveled out and put up to the right height. This should be perfect. Right now the pond's down a little bit, so this should allow for when the pond comes back up to have it be just right under the dock, which is exactly what I want. So this will be perfect. I know one thing I want to do is I want to come down here and get a ladder welded on the front of the dock so that you can go out in the pond and then come back and easily get back up on the dock. So, but yeah, holy smokes, what an absolutely gorgeous night. What do you have in your mouth? What is that? You're happy that you have that? Yeah, you're really happy that you have some grass in your mouth. Yeah, you are a happy, happy dog. Yep, go over there and wiggle. Wiggle. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. Go wiggle, 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 wiggle. Goofball. I came out tonight to sit in the deer stand and record the voiceover for some of this video and just kind of looking around and realizing just how beautiful tonight is and how nice this place is and how blessed I am to live here. Sarah's late grandfather said to me before he passed one time when he was here that, boy, you guys are lucky to have this. And at the time, I almost kind of took it like I was almost offended a little bit by it because I felt like at that time I wasn't lucky that I had earned this, that I had earned this place where we live. And I didn't think that it should feel lucky that I live here. I felt like that I wanted to live here. But I think looking around tonight, just how absolutely beautiful it is out here, how peaceful it is with the birds chirping and sitting here overlooking the pond from this deer stand, I think I get what he was talking about. I don't think he meant lucky. I think he meant blessed. I think that's what it truly, truly is. I think I know now I'm very blessed to live here. I'm very blessed to have this beautiful property and the opportunity to do things. And I don't know, sometimes I worry that maybe I'm gonna screw it up. Anyways, if you're looking down there, Pat, I think I get your message.